Honey mesquite is a thorny tree or regrowth shrub that can grow up to 30 feet tall when mature. The undisturbed growth form is typically a single trunk with a drooping, round crown. Disturbed plants may grow as multi-stemmed shrubs capable of forming dense thickets. Stout thorns up to 3 inches long are commonplace, and it may grow in all soil types. An invader species, mesquite can quickly reclaim an old field or fence row without follow-up treatment efforts. Honey mesquite is considered a number two choice browse plant in Texas. It grows in all ecoregions throughout Texas and is very resilient and stubborn. The value of mesquite is multi-layered in that it provides good forage for livestock, exotics, and deer throughout the hot summer months, and the beans are a highly digestible source of sugar, starches, and carbohydrates in the summer and winter months. The leaves help return nitrogen back into the soil, and older trees provide excellent shade, loafing cover, and sometimes roost sites, and mourning doves seem to prefer the lateral limbs for nesting sites. New growth leaves provide crude protein levels up to 25%, and older leaves down to about 16%, while the impressive bean pods average 12%. The bean pods are very important to most wildlife species throughout the hot summer months and oftentimes last into the winter months. The bark of young trees is tight, smooth, and gray-colored, while the older trees have dark gray bark with heavy, rugged, deep fissures present. The young or regrowth trees contain many stout thorns in all directions, while a mature tree may have few, if any, thorns present. The flower is a yellow-green spikelet that is attractive to bees, and the honey produced from mesquite is quite impressive. Honey mesquite provides landowners with a real love-hate relationship. Mature trees, often referred to as bull mesquites, are practically thornless and provide valuable shade and excellent bean production, while young or regrowth mesquite is much more problematic. Regrowth mesquite is quick to respond to any deep soil disturbance and can quickly dominate prime soils if you're not careful. Prescribed fire can control young trees and shrubs provided you have enough fuel to carry a hot fire, and effective chemical herbicides have been developed to control it on most rangelands. Grubbing or dozing is effective as long as you remove several feet of smooth root below the trunk. Top removal practices such as shredding or aerating or even mulching only makes honey mesquite mad, and it will return with a vengeance loaded with long, angry thorns.